With the many investment choices available, it can be overwhelming for beginners to determine how to best structure their portfolios. One popular component is equity securities, or stocks. By now, you may have a basic understanding of stocks, which are securities that indicate ownership in a company and represent a potential claim on part of its assets and earnings. Let's take a look at the two primary categories of stocks, common and preferred. When you think generally about stocks and their attributes, you are likely thinking about common stock. There are several different categories of common stock, which we'll explore in a later video. For now, we'll cover the basics. When you purchase common stock, you are considered a shareholder and therefore part owner of the issuing company. This ownership comes with voting rights that allow you to participate in the election of the company's board of directors and to vote on certain corporate policies. Other privileges that you may be entitled to are potential dividend payments, preemptive rights, or the right to buy newly issued shares before they are made available to the general public, limited liability in the event that the company goes bankrupt, and the entitlement to a portion of the assets of the corporation should it be liquidated. However, in the event that a company is liquidated, holders of common stock are the last to be compensated. This lower level of priority can make common stocks riskier than preferred stocks or bonds. Common stocks are also generally more volatile than preferred stocks and certain other assets, like bonds. However, they do have the advantage of a relatively greater potential for growth. Preferred stocks differ from common stocks in that they have characteristics of debt securities as well as equity securities. Preferred stock, like common stock, denotes a share in a company's ownership. However, it does not share the same propensity for growth as common stock and typically does not come with voting rights. Rather, like debt securities or bonds, preferred stock is similar to a fixed income investment as the company pays these shareholders a fixed dividend. However, unlike bonds, preferred stocks do not have a maturity date or set point at which the principal amount is returned. So, while preferred stocks may not offer the same growth potential as common stocks, they can offer a potentially stable source of income. As an added advantage, shareholders of preferred stock are given higher priority over holders of common stock. In other words, they receive their dividends first and take precedence in collecting remaining assets if the company is liquidated. Of course, bond and other debt holders ultimately trump both types of stock in terms of priority level for liquidation purposes. With all of this in mind, you can begin to determine your investment strategy. Remember, when choosing the types of securities that are right for you, it is important to acknowledge the inherent risks and consider your short and long-term goals, liquidity needs, and risk tolerance. To learn more about this and other investment topics, subscribe to the Zions Direct YouTube channel.